When you just started woodturning, you probably, I bet you made one time a twig pot. Lump of wood, nice shape, drill a hole in it, ready, twig pot. But what if we would make a double twig pot, one lump of wood with two nozzles on it? Like this. That's the secret we're going to reveal in the next video. Hello and welcome again in my workshop. The double twig pot. The magic revealed. Maybe you can put a little reverb on that. The magic revealed. No, it's not all that exciting. We're starting off with a piece of ash. With a bit of color in it. I like it, yes. Actually. And we just start by making it round. So how do we make it round? Find the middle. Find the middle over there. And there. And the same on the other side. And let the magic begin. Let's see if it runs, if it spins freely. It does. Like I said, make it round. Always keep a close eye on your work. Almost round. Switch off the machine, move the tool rest, turn the machine back on.
Wow.
Yeah, nice colors in this.
Yes.
In this lovely ash. Good. Let me make one more pass, so this is gone also. Good. Next step is make sure that I have two flat spots over here and over here. As you can see, it is, well, not actually flat over there. Let's make it flat. And on this side. There's no need to do this perfect. It's just that you can see the pencil lines that I will put in there. I will put a line there. I will put a line here. And approximately on the same over here. Put some more so that I can choose which one to take. Take it out for a minute, and now I will put a line in here, and I will put that line through the center, and if possible, perpendicular to the grain. And this line I also want to have on the other side. Therefore, I use my tool rest, and I will bring that line to the other side. Take it out again. And once again, the line from this point through the middle. Now I'm going to mark out a few points. This is the first one. That will be the center of my nozzle, and this will be the center of my other nozzle. We'll take the middle one. That will be a center point, and here's another center point. And now we go for the magic. Yeah, but you don't know what we're going to do.
No.
I'm going to be here on the ground. Okay. Two. Three. I'm gonna split it right in the middle. Three, two, one. Bang. Shit. Well, that went a little bit too easy. So now we have two pieces. And now you already feel the magic, of course, because if you glue these two back, they're round again. But
perfect, perfect cut.
Yeah.
Yes.
But if we stop the video now already, well, the fun would be over. So let's just move on. We have one piece and we'll put it back in center, but on the two points that I just put on there. One here and one here. That's pretty much unbalanced. If I can, if I want, I can move this point a little bit towards the center of the piece. Only if I do that, I have to do that on the other piece as well, of course. Yeah, let me do that. That'll make it a bit easier for myself. So we're going in. 1 centimeter. Will you remind me later, Lise, that I do that on the other one too?
Yes.
Okay. So, there we go. I see this pencil line now very clearly, and that is where I'm going in. And for all the people worrying about my face, that'd be probably my sister, but I'll put on a face shield anyway. in my tool rest a little bit so that it's easier to get to the wood with my gouge. I think that'll do. It is 43. Let's flatten this surface a little bit, sand it, and then we'll make a tenon on this side so that we can drill a hole. So that we can drill a hole on this side. Let's make a little curve in here. Oops. Okay, make a tenon over here so that we can drill a hole in there. That's most of the material removed. Now we're going for a nice tenon. And I'm always a bit whining about tenons. I think they have to be 52 millimeters exactly. That's it. This one is ready to drill a hole in it. Let's see if this goes into the center. Perfect.
Voilà.
Let's drill a hole 26 millimeters. I have two tubes that we can put in there so we can really put in a rose and give it water. Or whatever. Anyway, let's drill that hole. One more time. Yes, a nice piece of ash with a hole in it. You could call this an ash hole. So. We take out the first half and we move on to the second half. Well, actually, I should take out the chuck now, put in the drive center. But as I am a smart ash, my friend Simon Hope made the star drive. It's a nice, cute gadget. It's made for using it in a chuck. The inner rim here takes the sea jaws from Exminster and the Nova jaws, and the outer rim takes all the 2-inch dovetail jaws. You see? Perfect. And put a center in it. And now the center is away from the chuck, so the chuck is not in the way when I'm cutting here. It's the same producer as the thread cutter that you can see in me using in other videos. Cool. Anyway, move on to the next half. Oh, you promised to remember me.
1 centimeter,
thank you. And because it is exactly the same process, we're not going to... Well, please shorten this, please. So we don't have to look twice at the same thing. There we go again.
Go get some coffee.
Yeah, go. Go bring me some. So, time for an important
moment.
Make sure that there's no fibers folded on this surface. And also not over here, of course.
Nice.
Yeah, looks good.
Yeah.
CA glue, so I have to act fast now. Normally, of course, I would take wood glue, but because we are videoing and I can't afford lease the whole day to hang around here. Stop talking now and focus on your job. That's it. Wait a second. So we have glued these two parts together. And it is time to put it back in the lathe again. First, make as precise as we can. Determine where the middle is. Well, that is exactly where the split is, so that's good. And so that's the middle. The other side. There's the middle. Uh-oh, a bit too big. I have to get me a smaller life center. Here's another one. I don't have money, but equipment. Whoa. No, it doesn't fit either.
Is this the one?
I hope so.
Looks like it. Do we have a lift off?
Yes, we have.
Yay.
So. Last thing to do, get a nice shape over here and finish the upper side. Well, we've glued it not so long ago, so let me put on a face shield and put it down before I start the lathe. Let me make a foot here so that I can focus on the upper side of my shape. Too big.
this your launching device?
My launching device, no.
Looks like it.
No, it's just it's a practical thing. So you can do a bit of carving. I can't make a real nice smooth surface here because I can't reach it with a gouge.
Right.
So if you can't make it smooth, then make it rough. But make it rough as you intended to make it rough. There we go. Back to the lathe we go.
It's the episode with all the machines.
Yeah, a bit it is, yes. Gonna catch this one. Two tubes, and they go in so that I can also water my plants. I measured them, of course, before I put them in, and they were 1 inch, and we drilled a hole of 26 millimeters.
They will never come out again.
Look, Lise, what I have here. Ooh. Ooh.
Look at that. It's so cute. Oh, I really like it.
Oh, I hate it when...
Yes, of course.
Okay. Well, that is the secret revealed about the twig pot, the double twig pot with two ash holes. And that's it for this video. That's it for this video. Happy Easter. Please subscribe to my channel and all these kind of things. And well, bye. See you next time.